Paul's father, Sam Haber, was a New York City postal worker, and he taught Castilian Spanish at the local college. At one time, Sam had a tryout with the New York Yankees as a left-handed pitcher, but he didn't make the team. Sam Haber was one of the top handball players in the world and won major titles as a left-side doubles partner. He swept the ball inches off the floor of the court with a graceful left-handed stroke similar to the winding method he used on the Victrola in their Bronx home. His right-hand shots were effective, but his left-hand arsenal was the best in the world. He encountered the godfather of handball, Bob Kindler, a Skokie, Illinois construction kingpin who put all the top players on his payroll. The Haber family moved to Skokie. Sam and Paul began playing there with the top handball players on the earth. Kindler had the money, so Johnny Sloan, Gus Lewis, Ken Snyder, Jimmy Jacobs, Vic Herskowitz, and Lefty Call were all handball-playing employees of Kindler at one time or another. Kindler built an empire, but the Habers locked horns with him like a lot of the significant tournament players because of his complete control of all aspects of the perfect game of handball. Kindler killed handball for the AAU so he could have it for a personal toy. He prevented a professional tour that Paul Haber attempted to start with the owner of all the McDonald's restaurants in Canada. They even had a portable glass four-wall court that was to be transported by locomotive and rail cars. Kindler ensured its death by telling all the best handball players in the world that anyone who played in Haber's pay-to-play pro tour would be barred from all USHA events, and they could no longer receive financial help for their wives, girlfriends, and children. He also said he would refuse to bail players and their loved ones out of jail. In fact, years later, Kindler and his cronies would not put Sam Haber in the National Handball Hall of Fame until his son Paul said he would not accept his Hall of Fame induction in 1983 at Houston, Texas, unless Sam Haber got in the next year. It was that bold move that finally got his dad in the hall in 1984. Kindler was obsessed with getting four-wall handball in the Olympics, and after all attempts failed, he actually started a pro handball tour himself and even controlled the evil empire of racquetball in its infancy. He was a classic example of a man on a power trip.